The chief planner of the Mumbai Metropolitan Regional Development Authority, Uma Adusimile.
Thank you. I hope I'll be able to finish it in 10 minutes. Before I start, I would like to have a small update for Tony, that some of the details he has shown about the governance structure, especially vis-a-vis the spatial planning in Mumbai, needs updating. Yeah, I would like to sit with you and update. I'm just showing the location of Mumbai metropolitan region within Maharashtra. And Mumbai has Mumbai is a city of contrasts. We have this as well as that. In India, the metropolitan planning started in 60s. And the various states adopted two approaches to the metropolitan planning. One is adopting policy planning, that is regional planning approach, or very interventionist, implementation-oriented, development control-oriented, detailed planning of a limited area in the fringe of existing cities. Kolkata went for a different variety where it also looked at socio-economic issues rather than just looking at spatial issues. The National Capital Region planning in Delhi and the Mumbai Metropolitan Region looked at policy and coordination of the multiplicity of institutions that exist in their jurisdiction. The urban development authorities and some other metropolitan authorities in India, the urban development authorities do exist in several states in India. For most of the cities exceeding 300,000 population, they are all looking more at this interventionist way of addressing the problems of the metro cities. There have been 10 5-year national plans in India. And from 1 to 7, they looked at urban planning or housing as a welfare measure and therefore did not give the urban development due respect in terms of its contribution to the economy of the nation. The 8th plan for the first time recognized it seriously, and the 10th plan and the 11th plan actually start talking about urban development as a sector and infrastructure as a sector and devote serious efforts to detailing this further. The financial outlays for these two sectors together, housing and urban development, have never exceeded 3% of the national outlay. And coming to Mumbai, the first issue in delineating, the first issue regarding Mumbai metropolitan region was the delineation itself. The delineation could have been on the basis of economic integration or furthering economic interests which would have run from Mumbai to Pune all along a transport corridor. Or it could have been along the transportation corridor linking Mumbai to Gujarat state. However, they looked at the delineation of the region with focus on spatial planning aspects and therefore looked at mass transportation commuting distance, which actually forms the basis for the pattern of urbanization in the sub-district level regions around the Mumbai city. And therefore, it looked at homogeneity in urbanization pattern and included all those areas which exhibited high level of urbanization, much above the state's average level for inclusion in the Mumbai metropolitan area. And that was 30 years ago. And now the demand exists for extending this area to certain areas beyond Mumbai metropolitan region, which are exhibiting similar signs now. This is the way the region is today. It has 4 districts. Districts are the administrative units next to the state in India. And it consists of 20 urban local bodies, 7 of which are very big, almost larger than 500,000 population, and 13 of them are below that level, up to 100,000 population. And collectively, they had, along with 1,000 villages, had a population of 19 million in 2001, which is an additional 3 million by now. And the area is around 4,500 square kilometers. The urban component of the population is 94% in the Mumbai metropolitan area, while the area is about 20%. The kind of metropolitan development authorities in India, there are 5 major ones, and I could not put together all the data, but what is important is looking at the functions that they are playing today. While all of them are looking at planning and projectization and coordination as the major elements, Mumbai metropolitan region has the specialty of development financing on its major activities. Coming to how the spatial planning is seen in India, just to go further from what Tony said, we have a three-tier governance in India: central, provincial, which is state. Traditionally, urban planning is a subject of the local government. And the plans prepared by the local governments all over India are expected to be sanctioned by the state governments. That is the level where the state government intervenes, and central government has no role whatsoever in this, except that it has some legislation of related to environment which impacts urban development. And there was no, when metropolitan planning regions were delineated, this amendment to the constitution did not take place. So they were existing in good faith. And once the constitutional amendment came and placed the responsibility of urban planning on local bodies, another tier of metropolitan planning committees was created. And this instrument of planning at metropolitan level is going to be in place in Maharashtra. The legislation has been in place for 7 years. And the committees are actually going to be formed, and the nodal institution created for implementing the regional plan, that is Mumbai Metropolitan Region Development Authority, will actually be assisting this Metropolitan Planning Committee in this task. The Metropolitan Planning Committee's functions primarily include preparation of plan, and they really do not seriously go beyond that as per the legislation today. But it is expected that in course of time, probably following the West Bengal pattern, the terms of reference of this committee would go much further. The Mumbai metropolitan region has a lot of strengths. Its economic base strength, its public transportation is a strength, and the attitude of people here is a strength, and it has a great hydrometric area with three valleys, and therefore a lot of water flows through this area, and it has a great urbanization pattern with 20 large towns located within the region. There are a lot of opportunities of service sector industries getting concentrated here. It has weaknesses of containment of growth. It has hills all around, and therefore it has vast wetlands along the coast, environmentally sensitive areas. So there are limitations to the growth of this area, and it's not being very competitive in the recent past, and we would like to reverse that. Threats are competition from the rest of the cities in India. And the hill ranges in Mumbai metropolitan region are just indicated here. And these are the rivers which are acting as great sources of water supply. And these several projects are already earmarked for tapping these sources and providing water to the entire region. And this single agency established for undertaking the planning and development of this region has a planning coordination and ensuring balanced development as its mandate. And it has vast powers that will come in the way of undertaking this task. And we had prepared a regional plan in 1973, which was revised in 1996, and which is going to be revised once again in 2011. The first plan of 1973 was reflective of the times of socialistic thinking, prescriptive thinking, and identifying specific growth centers where growth was to be channelized. It did not succeed to a great extent. However, in 1996, when we went for a liberalized economy-oriented, market-oriented plan, with the growth, with the plan following the growth patterns that are observed, and where market was given free hand and regulatory mechanism were put in place rather than prescriptive projectization mode, 10 years later, that didn't succeed either greatly. So I think when we come back to our I'm skipping some of the slides which explain the land use details. The planning in this region had strength of great town planning legislative framework. It had a dedication institution, and there are good institutions here, and there is an industrial location policy, particularly for Mumbai metropolitan region, in place, which is environment impact based policy. But we have weakness of not focusing on housing adequately, as the Metropolitan Commissioner mentioned in his speech. And the approaches to regional planning across the periods are immensely varying. And we have inadequate proactive interventions. A lot of them are reactive interventions. And MMRDA as an institution is not as adequately represented as the Metropolitan Planning Committee is expected to be. So looking at the performance of the past, I'll just take one more minute. Looking at the orientation of these past plans, We are looking at the new plan to be based on synthesis of the two previous ideas, and to be interventionist where regional infrastructure is concerned, and monitoring growth trends, including economic growth, target and project driven, and it has a very sound basis of a comprehensive transportation study which is undertaken very recently. And it has all the cities here have development plans prepared. They also have capital investment plans prepared recently. And large-scale projectization has happened in this region. So all of this is going to help us prepare the next regional plan much better.